is up, guys? We are back with another video. And yeah, so we're gonna be going into the Dread Thicket. Let's see what this has in store for us. And like I said, man, don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment. I don't know why I couldn't speak there. And yeah, tell a friend about this video, man. For sure. Capturing it.
That would only slow me down.
Right, so real quick, what we're gonna do is we're gonna do this. We just gonna sell and store, sell and store, sell and store, sell and store.
What do you want? Make it fast. Hello.
We just gonna do that shit again, bro. The Dread Thicket.
That would only slow me down.
Alright. So we're just gonna do everything again. Nah, I have what? 228, 230? Alright, let's do the thing again. We just gonna sell everything I have. We just gonna sell everything we have. I'm not even gonna store it this time. I'll just sell it to him.
Speak.
Hunt, exile. I now will write a mighty poem about it.
Brody, he didn't even stand a chance. All right. Boy, you know, I just dipped on me. All right. We're gonna do this again. I don't know why I didn't start doing this earlier, but we're doing it now, so that's all that matters.
Hello. Speak.
Let's go. I'm telling you, bro, we ain't playing no games, bro. Securing everything, fam. No more games. Alright. Alright, in the meantime, let me do this. Auras from skills can only affect you. Aura skills have 1% more aura effect, 2% maximum mana, and they reserve 40% more mana reservation of aura skills. Why am I dying?
This seems like a good area to build a hideout, but it's filled with monsters. Can you clear it of everything dangerous?
Alright, let me drop all this stuff in the stash, and then I'll come back. As you complete quests, skill and support gems can become available at one vendor's in each town. One of the vendors in each town. This is actually kind of good. You better give me something, bro. I'm not doing all this shit for free, bro.
Curious. With the death of the last monster here, the very air itself feels different. I wouldn't use the word purified, but you've definitely negated the pall over this place. I'll stay here for now and make sure nothing dangerous reemerges. Welcome to our new hideout, Exile. I'll start getting it set up. All right. I've taken the liberty of performing a few tests. There are a few magical modifications the Transmutia device can make that are safe every time. Try enhancing a piece of equipment now. Let's see if my results hold. I retrieved the Transmutia device from the Chamber of Sins, and I believe I can rig it to imbue equipment with magical modifications. This may involve minor meddling with dark forces we don't understand, but we'll have to take that risk. Rayclast is a dangerous place, and we'll never get anywhere by playing it safe. As long as we treat the process scientifically and approach it methodically, we should be able to craft equipment to our needs. Malachi himself gave this Transmutia device to Malagara. It makes me incredibly uncomfortable to think about the horrors that it helped bring into being. But I must remind myself that science is not responsible for what happened in the Chamber of Sins. Science provides tools for mankind to manipulate the world. It is up to each of us to choose to do good or evil with the power so provided. Malagara was the evil responsible, and Malachi before him. Together, you and I are going to start using this device to undo the damage they did. While you're out there, try to remain vigilant for other possible locations for hideouts. The Blackguards never give up, and they may eventually stray close to this place. I want to have a backup location ready to go in the event we need to make a quick exit. I was no wonder child back in Aureath, but I prided myself on what junior accomplishments I managed to put together within the strict set of allowed sciences. Archaeology was my specialty, and Dominus and his ilk had an uncommon fascination with artifacts from the past. And I was told I was crucial, that I was important, because I could tell whether an artifact was truly Vaal simply by running my hand along faded stone patterns. I may have had a head slightly too big for my shoulders. When the Ebony Legion made available an archaeologist position on their expedition to Rayclast, and nobody volunteered, I thought my colleagues were all simply afraid of continental dangers. No. They knew better. None were allowed to speak it openly, but they knew. I didn't find out what kind of society I was truly a part of until I saw Piety's aspirations. I studied the Vaal. I knew all about their downfall, or at least our Templar-twisted perception of it. Piety's ocean of slaughter. The Vaal called their hubris the apex of sacrifice. The Eternal Empire called theirs the Purity Rebellion. We call ours the Temple of Lunaris. And I know nothing, Exile. Nothing at all. Save that we are doomed to repeat the mistakes of the past, unless we learn the hard way. When I first met him, I underestimated Einhar. Coming from the poorest of Ezimites, themselves already a battered people in this region of the world, Einhar struck me as someone who could contribute brawn to our cause, but not much else. How wrong I was. If anyone can decipher the dark design afflicting the creatures of Rayclast, it's him. I've been looking for the source of all this, an equation or overall pattern, but he's unknowingly taken an empirical approach. By learning about and understanding every single corrupted animal, and the energies their blood contains, he's done more to advance our understanding of the problem than I could ever have done myself. One day, he may even solve the symptoms of corruption without ever understanding the root cause. Make no mistake, Exile, that's impressive. A humanistic brute force approach to a cosmic problem.
I'm a treat.
type of leprechaun boots is that? Leprechaun boots, bro. Anyways. Let me go over here. Come this far and then yo, what is up guys? It is your boy Alpha, and we are back again with another video of Path of the Exiles, Trial of the Ancestors. And this is it, this is right where we left off. Northern Forest. And right now the mission that we're doing is that we have to kill a creature that's on top of a mountain. So yeah, let's do it. Oh yeah, before we even get into this video, remember to leave a like, subscribe, and tell a friend about this video. Alright? Other than that, we are all set. Pretty sure shit is about to get crazy in this video, so I might as well just give the video automatic like. Shit is gonna get hectic in this video, so just give the video automatic like. You don't even gotta think about it. Guys from the from that zombie area where I met the pirate. What the fuck is that? Thank you. And when the loot, when yeah, like I said, when the loot starts to really get over, when I start to get overwhelmed by loot, I'm gonna just make a portal back to the city and the town and stash that shit up. Ascend to the ancient pyramid. All right, so yeah, this is where we gonna meet the boss. Yeah. Oh shit! Look at this. They're giving me a waypoint, and they're giving me a crafting recipe.
I could nice. Hardly hope for better results.
They're giving me all this right before the fight. Shit about to go crazy.
What trouble?
I'm not even gonna sell it to him. Alright. Sold pretty much everything, so we have a good amount of space now to pick up anything that I kill. Anything that I pick up after I kill that boss fight. But yeah, it is 1 a.m. So just make sure y'all give the video a thumbs up for this. Ancient pyramid. Ooh, okay. Alright, so now we know where we at. Real quick, let me go to this waypoint so I can save. Alright, I just wanted to make sure I saved it. Y'all ready? Let me just upgrade and then you should be all set. Plus 14% damage. What's that strength? I'm gonna go for this. More mana. I thought it was going to be straight to a boss fight. not gonna lie. For how fast they shoot the lightning at you or the electricity, it's kind of slow. You would think if someone shoots the electricity at you, it's kind of faster. Than the level, bro. I'm telling you, bro, I'm starting to get tired of these fucking levels, bro. Like, I get it, it's high up in hell on a mountain and whatnot, but like, bro, it's just repetitive as fuck. Thank you. could. I wasn't shooting it because I was like, I'm gonna let my other shit kill him. But now, motherfucker just would not die.
That would only slow me down.
Apparently, I got too much shit. Stash all this stuff and then let's fight this boss.
What?
I looked at it like that, like the last second I looked at it and I was like, oh shit, this is better than what I have. I was like, oh, whatever bro, I'm gonna just fight this boss. Yeah. Well, I don't know what this is, but I think it's like electricity. I'm not sure.
Spread the word amongst your kind, Nightmare. You're not welcome in my world.
Yeah, man. Make sure y'all give this video a thumbs up. We did it, y'all. We did it. We did it. Your stash can be used to move items between care. Yeah. The city of Sarn. New spot, yes. Yeah, man. Oh, new area. Yeah, man. Make sure to leave a like on this video. Like, comment, subscribe, and yeah. Thanks again for watching this, man. We're coming a long way, and hope to see you here when we end the gameplay off. So, without further ado, it's 1:30. It's 1:30 in the morning, and I'm gonna edit this. I'm gonna edit a part of it right now, and I'm gonna upload it in the morning. So, yeah, man. Have a good night, y'all. And yeah.